Hi, this is Allie from the Terra team. In this video, I'm going to show you how you can organize data and tools and run analyses in the cloud in a Terra workspace. The workspace is like your computational sandbox in the cloud. It's where you'll do all your core work in Terra. Here I am on the workspace landing page, which is where you document everything. You can have an overview and a summary of the data and tools you're using to help collaborators and even your future self understand the work you're doing. On the right side of the dashboard is some generally useful information. There's the workspace creation date and your access level. Cloud information, including the URL for the workspace cloud storage. The other owners. And tags and notifications. Your workspace is designed to include everything you need to work in the clouds. The tabs on the top help with navigation. For example, the data tab reveals native data functionality. Your workspace comes with its own Azure Cloud Blob Storage. To see the cloud storage directory, click on the file icon in the right sidebar. You can create folders and upload smaller files right in Terra using the buttons here at the top. This one doesn't have a lot of data in it, but you can see there's something. And for larger files, you can use a command line interface or the Microsoft Azure Storage Explorer, and there's a link to step-by-step instructions for that in the description. You might need to store tabular data, and you definitely need to know where in the cloud your data files are. Your workspace includes integrated data tables to help keep tabular data and keep track of larger data files. They're like spreadsheets you might keep on your local computer, built right into the workspace. To see what's in the table, click on the name, which expands the table so you can see exactly what's in it. Here's an example of some mock data for a cohort of middle school students. Each row is data for a single student. Each student is identified by a unique ID. Each column is a different piece of information that goes along with the student. Your data tables can have as many rows of data and as many columns of metadata as you need. Columns can include information like links to genomic data files or phenotypic data to analyze, as well as information that generally helps you understand the data. Remember, data doesn't have to be stored in your workspace cloud storage to analyze it in Terra. You can include links for data in a public Azure data lake or other external cloud storage. Terra can use the links to pull the data into a virtual machine for analysis. Once your data is organized, you're ready to analyze it, which you'll do right in your workspace. Terra includes two types of analysis, bulk analysis workflows and interactive analyses. Bulk analysis workflows are a series of computational steps that you submit and let run. You can come back to look at the results when they're finished. They're often used for automated data processing tasks like aligning reads or calling variants. In many cases, you don't have to write your own. You can browse and import published workflows using the Find and Add Workflows section here. When you click the link, Terra will suggest some curated workflows, or you can import a workflow from GitHub, or search in DocStore and upload directly to your workspace. Once you have a workflow, you can set it up and run right in Terra by clicking the Configure button. You can view the raw code. You select the data table. Select the data to process. Select all of the data by clicking the single button. Next, you'll tell Terra where to find the input data for each variable. outputs get written back to the data table, and large files will be stored automatically in your workspace cloud storage. Once you've set it up, you can run it by clicking on the blue submit button. Terra will remember the configurations so you don't have to set it up the next time. You can name your submission whatever you want and even add some notes to help remember what the submission was supposed to do. When you click submit, Terra takes care of the details of setting up a virtual machine and running the workflow in the cloud. To monitor your submissions, click on the submissions history on the left side of the workflows page. You can see the one I just submitted is already running. There are a couple of previous submissions as well. If your workflow fails, you can get information to help with troubleshooting by clicking the submission that failed. You'll find useful troubleshooting information like logs up here too. The second type of analysis is interactive analysis with Jupyter notebooks. It's the kind of visualization and plotting that you often do after a workflow. You may have heard of or used Jupyter notebooks, which let you analyze data and visualize results in real time. Notebooks combine documentation, code, and data in a single package you can easily share and reproduce. You can store notebooks and run Jupyterlab right in your workspace in the Analyses tab. Click on the name and select Edit. Terra will spin up a virtual machine to execute the code. You can check the settings at any time from the sidebar. Choose how powerful you need your VM to be from the dropdown, and choose the disk type and size. When the Jupyter VM is running, you'll see the classic Jupyter documentation and code cells. Notebooks are flexible. You can do any R or Python analysis, and they let you visualize and iterate in real time. Colleagues can work together in Terra. Shared workspaces make sure everyone has access to the same data and analysis tools. You can share or copy the workspace by clicking on the three-dot action icon at the top right. To control what your colleagues can do in the workspace, you'll assign reader, writer, or owner permission when you share. Just remember, anyone with writer permission can accrue costs. Thanks for watching this overview of the features and functions of Terra on Azure. To learn more, visit our support online at support.terra.bio.